Good evening. We've lost one of our most loved Australians, Barry Humphries. The legendary entertainer died last night, surrounded by his most loved, in St Vincent's Hospital at the age of 89. But his legacy of laughter will live on in the characters he created. His alter egos, Sir Les Patterson and Sandy Stone, challenged and provoked us for decades. But perhaps our fondest memories will be when Barry put on a purple wig, a face of makeup, a dress and cat-eyed glasses and became Dame Edna Everidge.
The man who kept us laughing for nearly 70 years. Barry Humphries passed away last night at St Vincent's Hospital.
Barry Humphries, through his 89 years, made an enormous contribution to Australia, and he also showcased that uniquely Australian sense of humour to the world.
And his death made headlines around the world.
Breaking news, the Australian entertainer Barry Humphries has died.
Humphries was surrounded by his wife Lizzie Spender, his children and 10 grandchildren. In a statement, his family said he was completely himself until the very end, never losing his brilliant mind, his unique wit and generosity of spirit. His passing leaves a void in so many lives. The characters he created, which brought laughter to millions, will live on. In February, Humphries injured his hip after a fall in his Sydney apartment. There was surgery, but his condition deteriorated last week.
He's such a showman, I just keep thinking, surely there's going to be an encore.
In 2013, Humphries' finest creation, Dame Edna, crashed the royal box. The future king was in stitches.
They've found me a better seat.
A spokesman for King Charles said the monarch was saddened by the news, adding, His Majesty is writing privately to Mr. Humphries' family. Sir Michael Parkinson described Humphries as one of his favourite guests of all time.
You may not know this expression, but I am going commando tonight.
It's easy to forget. She started life as the humble housewife from Moonee Ponds. It was 1955.
Even the Venetian blinds seem to be smiling.
As a schoolboy, he dodged sport, but loved the arts and literature.
My mother was a wonderful character. I remember returning with her from what seemed to me a wonderful afternoon tea at the house of one of her friends. And I said to my mother, that was a lovely cake. And my mother just said one word, bought.
In 1972, Edna burst onto the big screen in The Adventures of Barry McKenzie.
This is me Auntie Edna.
Wake me up when we get to Gaypery.
No worries, Auntie.
In the sequel, she was made a dame by Prime Minister Gough Whitlam.
Arise, Dame
Edna!
Humphries and Edna took on the world. Talk shows.
This was another dress which Edna wore in an interview with Lauren Bacall.
That look, that beautiful Bacall look. I don't know whether I can do it. Little look you had.
TV specials.
A big hand for Sean Connery!
And the stage, Humphries' second home.
Oh, darling, a lovely little face too. Oh, I bet you were once an attractive woman.
I feel a strong sense of responsibility to my public. These people are there because they enjoy my work and they need cheering up. There is nothing nicer these days than being in the cheering up business.
And from a man so cultured, so civilised, he was able to conjure up the lecherous and all-round offensive Sir Les Patterson.
And you still was on a desert island with a pig.
No.
I mean, how did I get away with it?
Sir Les, Minister for Inland Drainage and Rodent Control, among other strings to his bow.
I'm chairman of the Australian Cheese Board. I was sitting on the cheese board only this afternoon, as a matter of fact. Bit of Tasmanian Stilton must have rubbed off.
There was plenty more in the closet. Sandy Stone, the world's most boring man.
Had a very nice night's rest.
I invented this kindly old man of the suburbs, really to see how much boredom an audience could take. It turned out they could take a lot of boredom.
He even found time to voice the shark in Finding Nemo.
Hello. Fish are friends, not food.
Humphries had been planning to take his one-man show around Australia next month.
But how long will I continue to work in a theatre? Oh, forever. Even when the audience is saying, isn't it tragic?
Edna, Celeste and Sandy, decade after decade, no other comedian came close.
I mean, it's often said that the best comedy works on the edges of a society, and its role is to tell us what's acceptable and what's not, and to provoke us into challenging that all of the time. And for 70 years, he did that.
And for all the adulation, Humphries once made this admission.
I have actually stepped onto a stage, heard a big ovation, and thought to myself, alone at last. I guess that'll be my epitaph.
Good night, possum.
Mark, such an extraordinary talent. One question now is whether his family will be offered a state funeral.
Pete, I think there's no doubt one will be offered to his family. The question is which state will offer. The New South Wales Premier seems keen on the idea but says it's too early to be approaching the family. Humphries' home state of Victoria is also enthusiastic about some kind of memorial or service and says it is speaking to his family. It could be a state funeral or some other way to honour his legacy. I think so many would like a chance to say thank you and goodbye. Pete.
Thank you, Mark. Barry Humphries may be one of our own, but he had a second home over the pond. The entertainer spent the past 40 years living in the United Kingdom, entertaining the people of London. Nine's Kari-Anne Greenbank joins me from London's theatre district, the West End. Kari, he was just as loved overseas as he was in Australia.
Well, Pete, here in the UK, Barry Humphries is being remembered as one of Australia's greatest comedy exports. And many of the weekend newspapers are featuring his alter ego, Dame Edna, prominently on their front pages. The Daily Star here reading, "Goodnight, Possums." But Barry Humphries moved here to London in 1959 to perform here in the West End, including in shows like Maggie May and Oliver. Dame Edna went on to become a huge hit over here in the 70s and 80s, meeting most of the members of the royal family, including the late Queen, during her Silver Jubilee in 1977, and King Charles and Camilla, with that particularly famous little skit alongside them in 2019. But it has been reported that King Charles called Barry Humphries in the days before his death and wrote him an email during his stint in hospital. Pete.
Kari, thank you.